Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Say, He is God, the One and Only, God, the Eternal, Absolute. He neither begets, nor was He begotten, and there is none like Him. If the Great Pyramid of Giza can slow down the time around it, and it's in the shape of a pyramid, why can't a throne? And the throne of Allah is much, much bigger than the Pyramid of Giza. It's much larger than the Earth, than Jupiter, than the Milky Way galaxy, the Andromeda, a supernova, a black hole, our whole universe. The throne is larger than all the universes combined, and then some. Allah says that His throne encompasses the heavens and the earth. Yes, this does mean that God's kingdom encompasses the heavens and the earth, but let's take it more literally than that. His actual throne encompasses the heavens and the earth due to its size. The throne is the base reference point of time itself, because throne time is the measurement that Allah is using, as that is where He is. Due to the way that the throne's gravity bends the fabric of space-time, time goes extremely slowly at the throne relative to the earth. Of course, the slowest that time can pass is no time at all. For example, at the center of a black hole, time doesn't exist. But we are talking about severe time dilation, not if time stopped. And the most severe time dilation relative to the earth and everything else in existence is at Allah's throne. So taking into consideration that time encompasses all things, then the throne, in terms of time itself, encompasses the heavens and the earth. Look at the miracle of the Quran. In one sentence, Allah says so much, how He, subhanahu wa ta'ala, gives us multiple signs from one sentence. His throne encompasses the heavens and the earth.
We can never imagine the throne of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. No matter how hard we try, it will always be completely different from what we see in our mind's eye. We only know what Allah has allowed us to know. Just a few examples of how big the throne is compared to all the universes. And He has allowed us to know 4% of the universe. Maybe it's a bit closer to 5% now. Either way, it's not much. At the throne where Allah has decided to be, time is passing very slowly. So slowly that when you think about it, it hurts your mind. Time is relative. So in throne time, a day is equivalent to about 2.3 billion earth years. At this moment in throne time, it is still the sixth day on the 11th hour. Midnight is approaching. We are on day six, and 0 hour is very close. Exactly when the hour will commence, only Allah knows. Allah says that the throne is the largest creation He has ever created, but He did not specify when exactly He created it. Time started at the birth of the universe, right? But when did throne time start? When did actual time start? At the birth of the throne. But when was that? Was the throne created at the precise moment of the Big Bang? Or was it created before that? If the throne was created before the Big Bang, then it has been more than six throne days. It's been 6 days for Allah since the Big Bang, and 13.82 billion years for the universes. But how many throne days, throne months, or even throne years has it been ever since God created the throne? Wouldn't it be strange to think that the Almighty has only been creating for 6 days? What about before the 6 days we know of? Is it possible that He was creating before, and that He will create after? Remember, Allah is infinite. He is not six throne days old. He does not have a beginning or an end. The seven heavens are six throne days old, and the earth is two throne days old, within the six throne days. But we do not know how old the throne is. Only Allah knows. Astrophysicist Neil deGrasse Tyson said something very interesting. He said, "We do not know what we do not know." In other words, there is so much mystery out there in the universe. We know this, but we do not know what the mystery is. So we do not know what we do not know. The universe is expanding and accelerating, and Neil says that one day it may expand so much that future humans will not know anything but the stars and planets of our own Milky Way galaxy. They won't know that there is anything else out there. All of the galaxies would be so far away that their telescopes won't be able to find them. Then Neil asked, what if this happened before? What if we are missing things that are too far away from us now? So it makes one wonder, how do we know that there has only been one Big Bang in the history of all things created by Allah? Only Allah knows. With the exception of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is not bound by space and time, everything else in the universe needs the fabric of space to exist. This is because everything is made of matter, except Allah. And matter cannot be without space. So the throne needs space. And before the Big Bang, scientists claimed that there was no space or time. Space needs time and time needs space. For example, if you want to meet up with a friend of yours, you can't just say, let's meet at the corner of Blue Street. Well, what time? You also can't just say, let's meet at 6 o'clock. Well, where? Space and time are combined. So in this case, if time started at the throne, then there had to be space. Maybe God created the throne at the exact moment he set off the Big Bang? Or maybe there are indeed more days than the 6 days that we know of. But Allah had to start from somewhere. There had to be a day one for creation. And maybe when the Big Bang happened, that was day one of the creation of space-time. However, maybe that was just day one for the heavens and the earth. Because God says that the first thing he created was the throne. Allah says, he it is who created the heavens and the earth in 6 days, and his throne was upon the waters, so as to test you, who among you is the best in works. From this verse, we can see that Allah's throne already existed before the heavens and the earth, and the water beneath the throne existed along with it. So either the throne or the water beneath was the first creation of Allah and anything else around those two creations. Or the throne, the water, and the surroundings, if there were any, were all created simultaneously. But what is clear is that the mighty throne and the water beneath were created before the heavens and the earth. So before the Big Bang.
Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that amongst the first things Allah created was the pen. The pen asked, what should I write? And Allah replied, everything until the last day. The pen recorded all the matters of the universe's 50,000 years before the creation of the heavens and the earth, so before the Big Bang. 50,000 years? What years? Earth years? Throne years? It doesn't matter to Allah because he is infinite. So even if it is 50,000 throne years, which is about 41.975 quadrillion earth years. So before he created the heavens and the earth and all the beings, he decided to create the throne and to have a record of all things in a book, the mother of books. Take computers and iPhones, for example. They record everything in code, like the Matrix. So even we do this. I wonder where we get this idea from. How God logs everything. No one knows. This pen, don't even bother trying to imagine it. We can't. Time was the first creation, because as soon as Allah created the throne, or the water beneath, time began. Allah says that he created the throne above water, and he created the heavens and the earth. So, the pen was created more than 50,000 years before the heavens and the earth. How long ago was the throne created? Only Allah knows. Not only is it the first, the throne is the largest creation of Allah, and as it sits on the fabric of space, it must be warping space-time like nothing else in the entire fabric of the cosmos.
God and his final prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us that there are seven heavens, and more including the hells and paradise. But the thing is, The first universe is so small compared to the second universe that even if the second universe was right in front of our noses, we would not be able to see it. The first universe compared to the vastness of the second universe is as small as a ring compared to a desert, after all. The second universe is 500 years away, and we do not know at what speed. Light speed? Even so, it is very, very close. Remember, the nearest galaxy to us is 2.5 million light years away, so 500 light years is very close. How is the second universe closer to us than the next galaxy? Maybe there is a wormhole connecting the universes, or the universes are superimposed. We could very well be living in a multiverse. If we are too close to something, we could lose perspective. For example, what do you see here? It's a melon. What about this one? It's the eye of a fly. So where is the second heaven? It's right there, up there, it's just too big for us to see. So then, where is the throne? Fascinating, isn't it? On the Day of Judgment, the throne will be brought forward above the plains of the earth. There will be 8 angels bearing the weight of the throne. We will be so close to it that time itself will be different that throne day. That day will not be equivalent to 2.3 billion earth years. That day will be 50,000 earth years long, because the earth will be larger and closer to the throne. Therefore, earth time would be slower than it is now. Instead of billions of years, it's just thousands, because of the gravity of the throne and how it bends the very fabric of space. That heavy day, Allah will destroy everything and bring it all back into existence, like He did the first time, or the first time that we know of, the Big Bang. But this time, everything will be everlasting. Before Allah brings everything back to life, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah will be alone for 40. 40 what? 40 seconds? 40 minutes? 40 hours? 40 days? 40 months? 40 years? 40 throne years? He does not say. There will be a period of time where we will not exist, but Allah always keeps His word, don't worry. He'll bring you back. He says if He wanted, He could bring us back with our very same fingertips. And we know that every individual on earth has a unique fingerprint. How can He bring us back exactly as we are? Well, Allah answers that as well. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that there will be a small part of our backbone that will remain, the tailbone, and Allah will create our bodies again with it, like how plants grow from a seed. How our Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam knew about DNA 1400 years ago is a miracle in itself, because why would Allah need our tailbone? So He can create our very bodies with our own DNA. And it is also incredible how our souls were formed from the backbone of our father, Adam alayhi salam. And this is what will remain of us, and we will be made again by it. This is all too easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, don't worry. You will be you. How it will happen exactly, only Allah knows.
Allah says, thereafter you will surely die, and on the day of resurrection, you will surely be brought out alive. Above you, we created 7 heavens, nor were we heedless of creation. We made the water descend from the sky in measure and settled it on earth, but we are in truth capable of blotting it out. We only know very little about the earth and this universe, let alone the soul and the other dimensions of the worlds. We only know what Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam have told us.
Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told his companions, may Allah be pleased with them, that Allah started the creation of the heavens and the earth on a Saturday, and the world ends on a Friday. Notice that this is 7 days, Saturday to Friday. Not only that, these are throne days. If Allah created the world on a Saturday, that would make Thursday, day 6, which is today. And Friday is tomorrow. Judgment Day is on Friday. People think Allah is just talking about Earth Days, Earth Friday. But what if Allah is signaling Throne Friday? Or the last day could be on both Earth Friday and Throne Friday. It could have been planned that way by the Almighty, the best of planners. Allah does not give us all the answers, He gives us signs. Because if He gave us all the answers up front, well, there would be nothing for us to ponder over, explore and discover. Allah wants us to ponder over His creation and the verses of the Quran. The Quran is a book of signs. All around us are signs.
An average human life is 71 years, which is less than a second in throne time. We have less than a throne second to do our best in this life, to be our kindest, most generous, loving, merciful, charitable, the best version of ourselves. We were created for one purpose, to worship Allah alone without any partners.
To worship does not just mean to put our heads on the ground for the Almighty. Although yes, this is the best form of worship, because this is when we are closest to God and how we show that He is the greatest. It humbles us so we do not forget how small and fragile we are. But to worship Him is so much more than that. Giving your own child a kiss on the head is a form of worship. Eating and drinking is a form of worship. Waking up in the morning is a form of worship. Going to work is a form of worship. Sleeping is a form of worship. Saying, "I love you," to your spouse is a form of worship. Breathing is a form of worship. Everything we do is a form of worship when we understand that everything we do is because Allah created us.
To God we belong and to Him is our return.
And without Allah deciding to create mankind in the first place, we would not exist.
All praise is due to Allah, Lord of all the worlds.